Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next subject, that is data communications. So we already know that the meaning of communication. A communication is nothing but the exchange of information between a person or between the systems and whatever it may be. So a communication is nothing but exchanging. And what about the data communication? A data communication means a data or information we are communicating from one system to another system. So let me explain the definition first. Data communication is nothing but it is an electronic transmission. We call it as electronic transmission of information or data. It's electronic transmission of information, or you can call it as data also. Data that exchange between two devices. You can take a devices or systems or whatever it may be by two devices via some form of transmission. So if you want to transmit the data, a medium is required, some form of transmission media such as wire cable, or you can take the wireless also. This was the definition of data communication. A data communication is nothing but it is an electronic transmission of information or data that exchange between two devices. If you take this as a device and this is a device, if you want to transmit the data from this system to another system, you require some form of transmission media. So this some form of transmission media, this is a transmission media, this wire. So this may be as a wire cable, or you can take it as a wireless. This was the definition of data communication. You just simply, it is a transfer of data from one device to another via some form of transmission media. Call it as a data communication. Okay. Now let us see what are the components that are involved in the data communication. A data communication system is made up of five basic components. Let me write DC. DC is nothing but data communication. A data communication system is made up of five basic components. What are the five basic components that are required to transmit the data from one system to another system? So those are message, it's nothing but a data. And the next component is sender. You require the sender, the person who wants to send the data, whether it is a person or it may be a system. Sender, receiver. If you want to send the data, you want to send to someone. The person who receives the data is a receiver. And medium, a communication. So something is required to transmit the data. It may be a wired or wireless. So that you call it as a medium. And the final thing is a protocol. A protocol. This was an important. Protocol is nothing but it's a set of rules. If you want to transmit the data, if you want to perform a data communication between the devices, you need some set of rules. Without the rules, you can't send the data exactly whatever you want to send. Okay. If you're doing something, means suppose if you're going on the traffic. So if you follow the protocols, if you follow the set of rules, then you can achieve your destination safely. In the same way, if you want whatever the work you want to do, okay, so that work you need to follow some set of protocols, set of rules. Everything is having some set of rules. If you want to grown up, you need to follow some set of rules, okay, to achieve your goal, like that. So these are the five basic components that are required for data communication. Whenever they asked about what are the components of data communication, let's write. You require the message, sender, receiver, medium, and the protocol. So let me show you in the form of diagram the components of data communication. Let's take here the sender was there. Okay. So here sender. And this side a receiver is there. So two components are over. Sender, receiver. So another component is you need to send some information, that you call it as nothing but message. This is another component. Okay, so you call it as also medium. Sender, receiver, and message, three components. And next one is you have to follow some set of rules. While the sender is sending the message, he has to follow some set of rules. Rule 1, rule 2, like that up to rule n. You call it as a protocols. In the same way, if the receiver wants to receive the data, he has to follow some set of protocols. That is the rules. Rule 1, rule 2, up to rule n. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and the 5, the medium. So these are the 5 components that are present for the data communication. So what do you call it as a message? A message is nothing but it is either a text or audio file or a video. Text consists of data, information, a data will be sending from sender to receiver. Or if you want, you can directly send the audio message or video message in the form of signals. Okay, so that is a message. And what about the medium? A medium is nothing but it is a physical path by which message travels. So here the message is traveling from sender to receiver. So this medium you call it as a physical path. It is a physical path which is used to pass the message from sender to receiver. It should be either a twisted pair, or you can take it as a coaxial cable or a fiber optic cable, or even you can take the radio waves also. This physical medium. And what about the sender and the receiver? The sender and receiver is nothing but here sends and receives the data message. So it can be a computer. You can take it as a computer, or you can take it as a telephone handset, or you can take it as a video camera, whatever it may be. So it's a device, sender and the receiver. Okay, and I already explained the protocols is nothing but a set of rules to send the data from sender to receiver. Here the system has to follow some set of protocols. So these are the components of a data communication. So whenever you asked about what is a data communication, just explained it is transfer of data from one system to another system with the help of a physical media. Okay, and the 5 components that are present in the data communication are the sender, receiver, message, medium, and set of protocols. Thank you.